Right now, just in this one, I'm going to concentrate on the differences between the song files themselves. In a future one, maybe I'll talk about the differences between the licensing between the two, etc., difference between the size of the database of the two. But now I'm going to say, hey, if we've got exactly the same song, what's the difference between the two? So let's head over to my computer. Presented by ChurchTechU, it's the ProPresenter Show. On today's show, the differences between a song from CCLI's Song Select and Multitracks. Hi, and welcome again to the ProPresenter Show. This is the show where I teach all about ProPresenter. My name's Paul Allen Clifford. And before we get started, if you're struggling to understand if you had the choice between Multitracks and Song Select, which should you get your songs from? Well, go ahead, tell me about it in the comments below and share this video with someone else who might be interested. So, Song Select and CCLI do have quite a bit of overlap in the songs that they both have. And they both have a license that enables you to do things like live stream or put up your words during church. So, which one should you choose? Well, right now, just in this one, I'm going to concentrate on the differences between the song files themselves. In a future one, maybe I'll talk about the differences between the licensing between the two, etc., difference between the size of the database of the two. But now I'm going to say, hey, if we've got exactly the same song, what's the difference between the two? So let's head over to my computer and we'll take a look at that. So first I'm going to click on search here, and I have accounts with both. So if I go here, Song Select by CCLI, let's just do a search for the song Egypt. Okay, so here in Song Select, sorry, that was this one. Here in Multitracks, if I go ahead and look at it, let's just, first off, notice that we've got exactly the same song, but with different album artwork. This is actually covered by different bands or worship teams, etc. So the words themselves should be very similar, although it might be a slightly different arrangement from one to another. So that's the first thing that you should know. Secondly, notice that it has all these symbols down here. The first indicates, hey, we've got words. The second is we've got chords for a chord chart. And the last one here is there's automation that you can get. I'm just going to go ahead and select this one and import it. And if you're familiar here, let me, I only have one library. We'll just bring that in as Egypt 1. So, having brought that in, you'll notice, first off, there's a check mark, lyrics and chords. If you just want to bring in the lyrics, uncheck that. If you want to bring in both, check that. So you'll notice that with it unchecked, we have four options here. One line per slide, two lines per slide, three lines per slide, four lines per slide. I don't know absolutely, but it is my theory. I haven't heard anyone say this, but it's my theory that if they were writing ProPresenter from scratch, this is what the interface would be. Because when you bring it in with CCLI or copied from clipboard or you import text, it's got a couple of less clear options that you've got to know how to use to get one, two, three, or four lines per slide. So do keep that in mind. I'm going to go ahead and select lyrics and chords, and notice I only have one, two, and four. I think that's because of how they've formatted the file on the back end. I don't fully understand how that's formatted, but I do know that they have. And we can select the key that our worship leader tells us the song is going to be sung in, because we can always change that just at a moment's notice. Select the theme. I'm going to change that theme to, let's see, this one, just because it's got a bigger thing there. Bring that into this particular library. Normally I have more than one library, but right now I've only got one, and then bring it into the currently selected playlist. I could do no playlist or select another playlist if I wanted to, but I'm just going to bring it into the currently selected one. So we'll import that, give it just a second, and there it is. So we're good here. One thing that I want you to know is, first off, we have the ability to change the key here, and we could even make it minor instead of major, just whatever, and we can do that pretty quickly just by clicking that down arrow. So that's one difference. Another difference is if I go to arrangements right here, notice that we've got multiples of a couple of things. So I've got multiple bridges here and multiple vamps here. And so they have arranged this a little bit differently. If I go down to this second bridge, do you like these videos, but you'd really like to learn from me in person? Well, I've got some great news for you. I am traveling around the country and maybe even around the world training churches on how to use ProPresenter. So I've got a either a 1 or 1.5 day class that you can attend. For more details, head on over to TDM.fyi/events24, the top one right here, and register for the event nearest you. If there is no event that's near you, no problem, you can request one. So head on over to TDM.fyi/class request. That's this one down here, and you can say, hey, I'm interested in attending a class, or even I'm interested in hosting a class. Up to you which you prefer. In the last one, that is just information. It's not obligation, so don't hesitate to put your information in there, and I'll let you know when there's a class in your area, or we'll talk about what it takes to host a class. It's probably a lot less than you imagine that it is. So head over there, and I look forward to meeting you in person. Notice that right here we've got the hotkey B for bridge, but for the second bridge, it's basically identical to the first bridge, but they've created it as its own group, which is not the way I would have done it, given that I know something about ProPresenter. What I would do is I would either repeat this bridge or call that like bridge 2 or something, so that it would automatically put the hotkey in. Notice the vamp, same thing. Now, vamp, less of an issue because in this case it doesn't have any lyrics that are being displayed, but I think probably I would do like vamp and vamp 2 or something. So that's a little bit of something to keep in mind. So this, as I understand it, is how that particular album had it. So if you were going to do a slightly different arrangement, you could go into the arrangements here and create one and then change stuff. But do know that this bridge is different from this bridge from ProPresenter's standpoint, and even though they've got the same name, and so therefore if you were to edit this bridge, it wouldn't affect this bridge. So that's, I guess, a positive. I just would have called it bridge 2. So that's something for you to keep in mind that's different. Now, if we go back here to the default, yep, I already added that from from Song Select earlier. I can tell that just by looking at the, not Song Select, Multitracks. I can tell that just by looking at this icon here. If I'd brought it in with CCLI, which I did here with Alabaster Heart, let's see if CCLI is, Song Select is going a little bit faster. Okay, there we go. So now if I bring in Egypt, nope, that's not the one, it's actually this one. Yes, this is it. And so if I click on this one, yep, these are all different songs, whereas in Multitracks it would have different arrangements of the same song based on which album you wanted to know it was coming from. This is more writer-songwriter centric. The other is more album centric. So keep that in mind as well. Now if I click import, we'll see a little bit different layout. First off, we don't have anything about the key that it's in because the Song Select stuff does not import the chord symbols or what key, etc. I wish it did. I wish we had some choices there. But secondly, it's got this confusing thing, parsing and delimiters per slide. I've explained this before, but while we're here, let me do this. So this first line is at, ProPresenter is asking, what do I look for when I take this text and split it? Right now it's the paragraph break, and only one paragraph break. If I wanted to bring it in identically here where we've got two lines, I would change this from paragraph break to line break and change delimiters per slide, because right now this is roughly analogous to one line per slide. So I would do two lines per slide. Same theme, same resolution, same library. Bring that into the exact same playlist, which is just the generic playlist is the one that I was using. And when I import this, I expect that it will either squawk at me saying, hey, we've already got one, change the name, or it will bring it in as like Egypt 1-1 or Egypt 2. So let's see which it does. So here it's saying, hey, yep, squawking at me. So let's do a new version just so that we can compare. And it's Egypt-1. And notice the difference here in the icon, this being the ProPresenter icon starting in ProPresenter 17. It was slightly different in ProPresenter 7.16.3 and older. So we've got that difference there. Now notice I've got verse, pre-chorus, chorus, verse 2, and bridge, in stark contrast to verse 1, pre-chorus, chorus, turnaround, verse 2, breakdown, interlude, bridge, bridge, vamp, vamp, interlude, outro, ending. So here, just to show you the difference, see, very simple here. This is concerned only about the words, and this is more concerned of exactly how it was it played for this particular artist that you imported it with. So again, kind of interesting there, the differences between those two. Same song, this one being more lyric-centric, and this one being more arrangement on that particular album-centric. So, just so that you know the difference between those. As I say, watch this. This is here on the Multitracks version, but when I go to the CCLI version, it is not there. So, also important to know about that, that you can do some stuff with the notes field and all to have that show up, but it just doesn't Well, it's not exactly the same. You would be manually putting it in the notes field, whereas this is automatic. So that's another difference between the two. So that's the differences between songs that you may get from Multitracks versus songs that you get from CCLI. If you like this tutorial, you'd probably like my ProPresenter Quick Start course, so head on over to tdm.fyi/proquick. Give me your name and email address, and I'll make a login for you for free. Till next time, this is Paul Allen Clifford from TrinityDigitalMedia.com and ChurchTechU.com, reminding you to go out and change eternity.